Have any last words?
You come into my house?
You destroyed my family.
You killed my men.
You killed my friends.
Would you kill an unarmed man? You? Elliot Ness?
That Elliot Ness is dead. You killed him yourself.
Papa!
Vittorio! Are you gonna kill me in front of my son? That stain right there is all that's left of D'Annunzio. One of my best men. I told him to take care of the butcher on East Main. One of the jerks who've been screwing with me for months. We had to make an example of him. Send a message to the other storekeepers. D'Annunzio ripped out his guts and hung him up with the merchandise. But he did it while the butcher's daughter was watching. Fucking D'Annunzio. There are lines that cannot be crossed. We have to protect the innocence of children. Keep them far, far away from certain experiences.
Your son should know what kind of monster his father is. I can't think of a better life lesson.
Look, Vittorio. His hand's shaking. Booze turns men into cowards. You'll be like your father. Never drink. It's funny, huh? The White Knight of the Volstead Act gets liquored up to kill the king of bootleg booze.
Relax, son. Nobody's going to kill anybody. I'd love to introduce you to a girl your age, Vittorio. Her name is Claire Dockers, and she sings like an angel. You two would get along. 2 days ago, Claire's father caught up with yours in a warehouse. Your father was hitting innocent people, and that's not right. He told him to stop, but your father ignored him and pulled out a gun to shoot him. Claire's father was quicker. He drew his gun first and fired, but the bullet jammed. Your father killed Claire's father, in cold blood. He kicked him in the face so many times, not even Claire herself would have recognized him.
You'll never prove I killed Dockers.
I know. And that's why I'm here. But now I know I'm better than you. Your father is a murderer, and Claire hasn't stopped crying these last 2 days, all because of him. Never forget that, Vittorio.
Hold it! Let him go. Run, Ness, and forget I exist! Or I'll have to report what you just did. And I do have witnesses. You hear me, nurse?
Mm-mm-mm. That's some first-class pie. Appreciate it. Thank you, sir. My car is parked outside. If you could join me as soon as possible, I'll be doubly grateful.
Gentlemen, I'm closing up. Time to move along.
So early? What are you talking about, Ness?
Are you serious?
I'm sorry, guys. I have to close up. Today's meal is on the house.
Oh, yeah? Tomorrow's, too. Or I'm not coming back. You got that?
Whatever you say, Dickinson. That's how a bullet turns into a boomerang.
At last, Mr. Ness. Please get in.
How do I know this isn't a trap?
How do I know you can be trusted? You just kicked your customers out in the middle of their meal. Please get in. I can't afford for you to catch a cold.
We'll be going up in a couple of minutes. I'll wait for you in the cable car.
Up where?
Okay, let's go.
Scared of heights?
Hey, you sure we don't know each other?
I never lie, sir. If you need a paper bag, I have one.
How high does this thing go?
Higher than the clouds.
I'm afraid I can't come with you. Thanks for the pie.
But...
Welcome to the Grand Hindenburg Hotel. My name is Susan, and I'm glad to be of service. Your name, please?
I'm Mr. Untouchable.
In that case, I suggest you try not to live up to your name if you want to make the most of your stay at the Hindenburg, Mr. Untouchable. And now, how can I help you?
I'm here to see Mr. Capone.
There's no Mr. Capone here, Mr. Untouchable.
Listen, Susan, I know more than 60 aliases for Al Capone, so you have two options. One is to delay my appointment with him until I guess the right one, which he is not going to like. The other is to send me through and earn my eternal gratitude and his. Your call.
He's in the presidential suite, top floor at the end of the red carpet.
Thank you, Susan.
Have a pleasant stay at the Grand Hindenburg Hotel, Mr. Untouchable. Your attention, please. The cable car to Santa Esperanza leaves in 3 minutes. You can't go in there, sir. They're in rehearsal.
Theater?
Shakespeare's Titus Andronicus. They open in a couple of nights. Perhaps Mr. Capone can get you a ticket?
Capone? He's at this hotel? Gosh, I'd heard the opposite.
Your attention, please. The cable car to Santa Esperanza leaves in 2 minutes.
should be rotting in jail.
That's exactly what I've been doing for the last 19 and a half years. You'll be surprised what a little good behavior can do for a person. You're not gonna ask me for my last words this time. I'm a lot closer to death than when I last saw you. As are you.
Why did you ask me here?
Why did you come?
I wanted to see if you'd improved with age. I'm glad to see the answer's no.
When you said rot in jail, you really meant it, huh? Look, I didn't ask you here to find out who's got the snappiest comebacks. I want to hire you.
What?
I require your services as a detective.
What's your game? Who do you take me for?
Look, Ness. My granddaughter Sophia has been kidnapped. When what happened to my son, Vittorio, I put her in a boarding school. She was entered under a false surname, Colombo. Nobody knows who she is.
Nobody?
Only Milton, the man who brought you here. I trust him completely. 2 days ago, a guy turned up at the boarding school. He introduced himself as Guido Colombo, the girl's uncle, and her new legal guardian. He said her parents had just died in a tragic automobile accident. He produced all the relevant papers, driver's license, the custody document supposedly made out by the father, the death certificates. He explained away the fact that the girl didn't know him by saying he moved to Seattle before she was born.
Any clues?
Nah. Well, Sophia was wearing a blue dress with flowers that I personally ordered for her from Italy. She was also wearing white ballet shoes with daisies embroidered on them. As for the guy, the school principal said he was tall and slim, in his 50s. No particular accent. Black hair, no beard, no glasses. Well-dressed. Could be anyone. But I know he was hired by one of my old associates. Someone wants to finish me once and for all. Maybe they want control of what's left of my organization. Maybe they hate my guts.
And I thought I was the only one who still hated you after 20 years. What else have you got?
I got this. And I got you.
You don't have me. My place is at my diner. And your girl's not there.
Huh. So where should I be looking?
You were the biggest boss in the Mafia, and by the looks of this place, you didn't lose everything. Why don't you ask one of your subordinates for help?
You don't listen, do you? The kidnapper was hired by one of my men, one of the people I trust.
So why me?
20 years ago, I pushed you to the edge. I bought your friends and killed the ones who couldn't be bought. I got you so obsessed with me that your wife ended up leaving you. When you had nothing left, you walked into my house, shot my bodyguards, and pointed a gun at me. You could have killed me. But you chose to take it out on this piano. You're the only honest man I know.
I'll do it. Not for you. For her.
I knew I got the right guy.
But I want something in return.
As you can see, I'm not short of money. Ask. I won't haggle.
You confess to any crime you like and go back to jail forever.
That won't be difficult. Since I got out of jail yesterday, I've committed a few. I don't give a damn what happens to me, Ness. You just saved Sophia. and you can start by investigating
Carlo Boccherini.
How did you know?
Biggest forger in Santa Esperanza. Wouldn't surprise me if Sophia's so-called uncle's papers were made by him. Besides, he's been cursing your name ever since we put you in jail.
Hey, I treated him like a son.
After you killed his parents.
They were selling booze without my permission. Wait, you know where to find him?
I have a good contact at the station. A girl. Rookie. Straight arrow. Reliable.
A girl? You saying you trust her?
You are such a chauvinist. Do you trust me?
Deal? That's a spirit. Keep Milton informed at all times, huh? You hear me?
I know you from somewhere.
You're not gonna ask me for my last words.
You should be running. I'm never going to help you. Why me?
I'm not asking you to help me.
I'm not a cosmic. I'll do it. Not for you. For her. This town has become a jungle. Where not even the rats are safe. Fight to steal the last scraps of dignity we have left. And those who shall judge them prefer to squabble over their prey. But it wasn't always like this. The Santa Esperanza I was born in was a clean town. A place where it meant something to be a cop. I knew you would, Alice.
Write this down. 31 Wicker Avenue in Lakeview.
Thanks. Nice work.
Elliot, what do you want with him? He's got a hell of a file.
I think he's mixed up in a kidnapping, but my client doesn't want the police involved.
What are you getting yourself into? Who's your client?
Alice, I don't have much time. I'll let you know how it goes. Thanks. Tomorrow's going to be a long, long day. 31 Wicker Avenue. This is it.
You sure?
I'm sure.
At last. That stench of stale grease about you reminds me too much of my old job.
I smell of grease?
Yeah, I don't think anyone else would notice. But when you spend a part of your sentence as a chef in the kitchens on Gore Island, you smell it a mile away. And how do you think I met Alphonse? Playing golf?
Alphonse?
On the subject of cooking, I know your blueberry pie had an extra something. I still don't know what.
Alphonse?
So what now? You got a plan?
Take a look around, in case there's a rear exit. I'll take the main door.
My pleasure.
Baccarini?
Nothing of interest out back. Sorry. You better come see this, Mr. Ness.
What is it?
I don't know how to describe it. Is that our man?
Baccarini.
My God.
We have to find out who did this and why. Let's go.
You're the detective, Mr. Ness. Besides, Alphonse will want to see this. I'll be right back.
All right. I have to establish how Baccarini died. Maybe the body parts can shed some light on the motive. To establish how Baccarini died. Holy Christ, what the hell are we up against? His eyes were pulled clean out of their sockets. Whoever did this, it wasn't their first time. And if they committed any other murders like this, it's likely that the police found some of the bodies. I must remember to ask Alice. Pity he won't last till Christmas, because he'd almost pass for a tree. There's no doubt the murderer took his time. Killed. The buildup of blood inside his mouth speaks for itself. This isn't a cut, it's a tear. His hands were ripped off. Who has that kind of strength? Looks like the bottom of a glass. It's Boccherini, no doubt about that. Although the one I remember was more together. The blood comes from the other side of the corridor and ends next to the body. He was attacked in the other room and dragged to the hall. The evidence suggests that the events began in the lounge. How did Boccherini encounter his murderer? Whatever crushed the table must have been really heavy, or maybe it was thrown extremely hard. Like water. Fingernails scratched the wood. A perfectly circular dint, as if someone had tried to hammer in a gigantic bolt, around 4 inches in diameter. Takes off a wristwatch without unfastening it, or fastens the strap again after taking it off. Did it break during the struggle, or was it already broken? Blood. Blood everywhere. This was opened recently. One knife's missing, the biggest one. What is it with Italians and olives? They lap those things up like caviar. Bachelor, he should have put these into soak. Hours of scraping to get them clean. Although at this stage, I don't think Boccherini's too worried about that. 4 glasses. 2 of water, 2 of wine. I've always been a whiskey man, but I know a good wine when I see one. Leftover lasagna. And it looks good. Why is it that 2 out of 3 Italian gangsters are great cooks? I'll never understand what the deal is with them and cooking. The plates and the glasses leave no room for doubt. Boccherini had company for dinner. Shut from the inside. on the floor indicates the window was broken from outside. There's something under there. How'd it wind up under there? Not one round fired. It must have happened fast. Takes a strong man to tear that out, or several. What looks like the bottom of a broken glass buried in Boccherini's back. The murderer tore Boccherini's hands off. Boccherini's teeth were all pulled out, hands ripped off, teeth torn out. I guess I'll have to rule out criminal intent or a personal angle. Boccherini's eyes still haven't shown up. What if I look for whatever was used to remove them? A blood-stained wristwatch. A broken table. The trail of blood from the two pools of blood. What looks like the bottom of a broken glass buried in a broken table. A blood-stained wristwatch. A door in the kitchen. Pieces of glass from the window in the hall. A pistol, fully loaded. The lamp, torn off. An open bottle of whiskey. I'd say Boccherini was drinking in the dining room when his assailant burst in through the window. Boccherini pulled his gun, but the murderer disarmed him before he could shoot. Where did the torture begin? The blood-stained wristwatch, with the glass broken and the the lamp. A door in the kitchen. Dirty plates. A broken table, scratched and covered in two pools of blood. One of the bloodstains show that the murderer began to torture Boccherini on the dining table itself. That was where his hands were torn off. As a result, his wristwatch fell to the ground. How did the body reach its current position? A door in the kitchen. The lamp. Torn off its bracket. The trail of blood from the dining room to the hall. Boccherini, already minus hands, was dragged into the hall, where the murderer used the brackets of the lamp to complete his macabre diorama. Shut from the inside. Maybe between the two of us when Milton gets back. If I'm not mistaken, this door opens onto the same room as the locked door in the kitchen. Blood and some kind of sticky liquid. I should have stayed in my diner. Thank you. these teeth from the body? Well, at least I know why his teeth were pulled out, more or less. What is that? Looks like a ritual. What was Boccherini mixed up? Stained with blood and some kind of sticky liquid. The mixture of sticky liquid and blood can only mean one thing. The spoon was used to remove Boccherini's eyes. The mutilations and the disappearance of his eyes suggest two possible motives. Psychopathy or cultist fanaticism. Which is it? A sick altar of human. A door in the kitchen. A door in the corridor jam. Some kind of symbol drawn in blood, though I don't know the origin of the symbol in the bathroom and the altar of flesh and teeth. I'd say the motive was some kind of occult religion. The big question is, who did it? This car looks too classy for a forger like Boccherini. Are there sufficient reasons to believe that when the murderer attacked Boccherini, there was someone else in the house? The first possibility to be ruled out is that the car belonged to Boccherini,